somebody is wonderful to be in the house of the Lord. I think the person who hear you right, the person is wonderful to be in the house of the Lord. It is time to give testimonies, but before that, let me say this to us. Testimonies authenticate the reality of God, and by so doing, destroy that. Hallelujah. When you remind God of his previous acts, you invoke his faithfulness and compel him to reproduce those same acts once more. Hallelujah. God has been faithful to us. It had been because of the mercies of God. I don't know where some of us may have been by now. But because of his faithfulness, because of his grace, because of his love towards us, we are privileged to be here and to be here at this time. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are here and you have a testimony, as I said, somebody's faith is dependent on that testimony. Can you walk up to me and share it to the glory of Jesus? Clap your hands together as they come. Appreciate Jesus as they come. Appreciate Jesus as they come. Hallelujah. Jesus.
Hallelujah. My name is Joshua. My testimony is this. After the close of prayers yesterday, as I was about to reach the road, so I saw St. Andrew, we greeted each other. On reaching the road, I looked at my right, that Flagon Bridge, towards Flagon Bridge. The place was covered with dust. I looked at my left, there was no way to come, so I decided to cross the road. Just by crossing the road, a bus from that dusty environment was coming towards me with full speed. All of a sudden, I started running and running until I stepped on a stone. The stone now slipped me off and threw me on top of a slab on the other side of the road. And I then noticed that I had no injury in my body. I got up. It was only my phone that the screen got back. So I got up and looked at the phone.
And the house is gone, but it's not even that I would say I'm leaving the house for them. But since 2016, the house was fire. I can't even afford to pay the house rent. And I think that you guys pray for me and say this thing is not happening. And I went to your office one day and I saw my laptop to sow a seed to make things happen. That is what I told him. It gave me 3 months. That I will be able to park from there. And I thought that if I am able to get the room, the single room, then I will die for the rent of the one. But right now, I'm telling you, I'm living through the new set of time. And she had the faith that if the man of God prophesies to you, don't take it as a joke. Take it so very serious and it will manifest in your life. Hallelujah. God bless you so much, brother. Thank you. Please God. Amen.
You tell us your name and then your testimony.
Praise the Lord. My name is Pastor Reed. Last week's Sunday, I was having a leg problem. When Daddy started praying for us and said, if any of us is this thing, we should come outside for the testimony. Due to when I was checking my leg, I can no more feel the pain again. So I have my testimony. And also this week, I have some problems, which is on Monday, where I was arrested and they wanted to put me to court. I just want to thank God for everything, because if not for God, I know by now I could have been facing the challenge of crazy years. So on Tuesday, they promised me that if nobody came to ask of me, definitely they would take me to court.
because they said since no one is coming to answer for him, I have to serve jail and use for my replacement of money. So I met a man of God in the cell, which was praying for me that I should not worry, everything will be alright. I have nobody to call, so I called Daddy and told him everything. The first time I called him, he said, okay, no problem. He put the end the call. Second time again, I called the IP of my issue, called him. He didn't pick. I said, well, what is going on? Or is that I'm going to end my life at jail? So they put me inside the cell, but the man of God told me that I should not worry. And help will come to me. So on Wednesday, they called me. I'm part of those they want to talk to court with three other men. I started praying. I prayed. And the time they were supposed to take me to court was by 11 o'clock. So suddenly, I saw mommy and the pastor came there. They came and said, they came for my family. As I said to you, and also I want to thank everyone for the contribution of my religion. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Listen, you give us a name and your testimony.
Praise the Lord, brother. My name is Saint Grace, Dickens and Macy. I'm here to celebrate the God who preserved my life again. It sounds funny to me, but it was real. You know, I think everything funny, but at the same time, they are serious. What I'm trying to say is that the taxi man slept while driving. But me, I wasn't focusing because I was on my WhatsApp chatting. The only thing I could saw was that the taxi went up and came down, bang, like that. Then I turned to me
and you are sitting down. Jesus was awake in that taxi. The driver was asleep, but God was awake in that particular situation. I see God be awake in your situation also. Clap your hands together and celebrate you for something. What do you have to say to the God of HTL?
What I have to say to the God of HTL? I will say, there is God here. You just have to believe and keep to his word. Just believe, that's all I'm saying. Believe.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Believe, does somebody believe?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This testimony is not about me, but my brother. I'm in Zion Branch. On Wednesday, I came here with my family, and then Daddy located some of them. On Friday, they came for all night, but I didn't come. During the service, my brother had instant miracle. He was having a problem about the time for about 8 months that he went to endpoint. Hospital for some drugs. Because of that, they're giving him time to eat and they stopped him from eating certain food. But on that Friday, he had his meal. And this brother of mine, before you meet him or bring him to another church, it's very difficult. For about a month, I was talking to him for us to come here for prayer, but he always disappointed me. But on that Wednesday, I have to cite him, tell him what our Papa has done for me before he came, and I give thanks to God. And I'm praying that he will join this church.
Hallelujah. Because of that pain he was having.
said, he comes there to do something, not to kneel, not to. You find it difficult to pay.
But after that day, what is the changes man has seen?
Now he can keep. He goes for jogging.
Come on, celebrate Jesus. By one encounter in his house, that pain left him. Celebrate the God of Israel,
someone. Celebrate the God of Israel. What can I say to you? Tell us the name of this man.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
My name is Akemi. My testimony goes like this. Past 8 years, I was drinking, happy of drinking. When I have money in my hand, I use all money to drink before I realize my money finished. But on 11 October 2017, that Wednesday, I came to this church at the God side, and prophet prayed for me. From that day up to now, I stopped drinking. Into the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please feel at home as we journey into the supernatural. Whatever is about to come to us, open up your heart and receive. The blessings of the Lord are about to be released unto us, open up your heart and receive. Once again, it's a pleasure having you with us. Stay blessed, and may the God of Israel be with you. Clap your hands together.
Before I take my seat, I'd like to just make this announcement to all of us. If I kindly put off the phones or put them on silence, that is to help us minimize disruptions and calls coming in and that. So if you have your phone with you, you can kindly put it on silence or you put it off. The protocol team is also there. If you are feeling pressed, just signal them. We'll take you to where you can actually use yourself. God bless you so much.
And then
they chat for
Hallelujah. today I want to share with us a subject that I have named the seed in me. The seed in me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So turn to the person next to you and say, the seed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
A seed in me.
Abba, a woman.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And let us look at 1 John 3, verse 9. The book of 1 John, chapter 3, verse 9. First John 3:9. And we are going to read the word of His grace. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's because of the seed. In the person. So now let's look at the seed of God. The Bible says that when you are born of God, the seed of God remains in you. When you are born by God, God's seed remains in you. And we know that a seed contains within itself a future plant. Therefore, the seed of God contains in itself a future God. The day you become born of God, the seed of God is planted in you. And the seed of God contains within itself a future God. Because every seed, like a seed of a plant, from which a plant germinates, when you have orange seed, inside the orange seed is orange plants. And when the plant comes out of the seed, it produces oranges. And inside the oranges are seeds, which also have the potential to bring out a plant of orange. Can I tell you somebody here? When you are born by God, the seed of God is in you, which is inside you, is something that has the ability to bring out a future God.
That's it.
I'm
here.
Whosoever is born of God cannot sin, because the seed of God remains in him. Inside you is the seed of God. Inside you is the seed of God. Inside you is the seed of God. One of these days, the seed of God in you will germinate.
Awaits
the manifestation
to manifest this, to come into play. The plan of God for the child of God is like that of a caterpillar growing into a beautiful butterfly. What God has done to those of us that are bound by Him is like that of a caterpillar that metamorphosed into a butterfly. A time is coming. You sitting down there, that you are born by God. You are going to metamorphose into God. And so watch the screen. On the screen you are seeing a picture of a caterpillar changing into a butterfly, and you almost cannot see the fullness of the caterpillar. And when you look at the last one, you now see that, not this one, you will see that now you can't see the caterpillar again, but now you are seeing a moth.
Are
you hearing me? You are seeing what came out of the caterpillar. When you are born by God, it's like that of a caterpillar. How does a caterpillar grow into a butterfly? A caterpillar that moves like this. It moves like this. How does that caterpillar change itself into something that flies? You are sitting down hearing Apostle Eric.
What has he was not
and you are born by God. And you have no idea that a time is coming. If you will constantly look into the Gospels and meditate on them and practice the word of His grace, one day you will be no more and Christ will come out of you. This is what happens.
Say never.
As the caterpillar grows, the caterpillar sheds its skin about 4 times or more.
And
the caterpillar is growing. It sheds the skin. The more it grows, it sheds the skin until it gets to a level that the tissues in the caterpillar breaks down, that there will be no more caterpillar, and the butterfly comes out of it. When it's growing, then the body removes the cover continuously. And one day, the caterpillar will say, I will not eat again. Listen to it. There's a price to pay. The caterpillar pays the price. The day the caterpillar will change into a butterfly, the caterpillar makes a decision. I am not eating again. And the caterpillar hangs, looks for, there's a particular leaf or a tree
This thing you are seeing there. It's a pathway to you. He looks for it. Either the leaves of it. Or the stem. Or the branch. Then he will stick on it. Upside down. Which means the caterpillar will use his legs to hold the leaves and the head will come down. And the caterpillar will spin itself. It will be spinning itself.
Not
it. Can't be there. And why? It will spin itself.
As
he's doing that, it's being changed. The body is breaking down. And the butterfly inside is forming out. It's coming out. Are you hearing this? And as I speak to you now, you see me as God? No.
Anyone
that look at us, you don't see us as God. Because they don't know what the seed is. The seed contains within itself a future plant. Now they can't see it. Until we begin to plant our seeds. And the seed dies. And then the plant begin to come out. Put off the old man. And put on the new man. Stop living in sin. Stop living in sin. And begin to walk in righteousness. Get ready for something. This one is only for those who walk in righteousness. And the pastor said you can't.
The pastor said
whosoever is born of God cannot sin. Then you understand I am born of God. God is my father. You cannot sin. It's cursed. Why are believers singing? They are not grasping that they are born of God. I'm not saying they are not heard it. I said they are not understood it. Do you know what it means to say I am born of God? You will not play around these days. No one is born of God can't see. The seed of God remains. What manner of love is this? That the Father has bestowed upon us that we should be called the sons of God. He said, therefore, the world know us not. I said, they don't know us. They don't know who we are. They are still looking at us as people like them. And before, those of you who are in this commission, the world should be ready for you. I said, the world should be ready for you. They will see you at night entering to the room and say, bye bye tomorrow. And the next day, they will knock on the door calling you. And a total different image will appear.
Anymonium.
Is this side?
A woman.
It's here.
Anymonium is show.
Strong.
Young lady at the back there, you
want to
take it. Look at me. Look at it. It's everywhere. You don't really like it. People will like it. You want it. You want it. You want it. These things are real. All about the nations of the world. The things of the spirit that Christ brought to us have not yet been grasped. The seed of God is in us. We are emerging. We are coming out. Is there somebody here with a headache? Strong pain in your body. Come here right
now.
Give some. Strong pain. Come here. If you are here and you have been having sex and dream every day, the one who's having it almost every day.
You are one of the PR.
I want to come here and pray for you.
Sex and
dream every day. Yes, what is happening to this man?
Now, this man is having pains around his waist, his weight, and his spine.
This serious?
Yes, severe pains. Severe pains.
The waist?
The waist, the spine, and then the left root to be precise.
How long has it been? Please, can you have the people there? The pastor should put them on the back. So what is people having challenge in their body? And they are going to be healed. Free.
Because
how long has it been? Hey! Except for his waist, almost 3 years. How many years? Almost 3 years. Stretch your hands towards
him.
Pray for him now. That it goes. Stretch your hands right now. Pray for him now.
This
thing goes now. 3 years suffering pain in your waist. Please pray for him now. That pain is going to now. Saints of Christ, stretch your hands up front.
I want to form a snowman, sir.
Can I hear your voice? Lift up your voice. In the precious name of Jesus.
Oh yes, again.
I command this
wisdom
to go out of you. And I speak healing to you. Let him check himself.
There is a mirror in the house already.
Okay.
this man used to experience
severe. Let's celebrate the miracle before we go.
Happens, he has to either bow down his head or do something. But according to him, when he came to service this morning, the pain was too much. So he bowed down his head like this. Then the pastor walked up to him, assuming he was sleeping, and then he narrated the issue to the pastor. The pastor only told him that you are here.
Pastor did that.
Pastor did.
You did that. You walked to him. He bowed his head.
Yes, because of the hammer.
What has happened now?
So the man of God just told him that you are ill.
Okay, and he said that to him.
He said that to him. From that time to now, the pain has disappeared. This for a couple of years now.
Couple of years.
Yes. After that evening, he said he felt some like water just flowing through his body. Yeah, that was what happened to him.
Come
here.
Give glory to Jesus. Get out.
Now.
Jesus.
he feels some cracks at his spine. But as I'm talking to you now, he's breathing heavily, and there is no sign, there is no sound of that crack anymore.
God has told him to heal him from the skin.
You know this man? He said when he takes in a deep breath, he feels cracks.
Now after healing,
he's taking a deep breath.
For me.
You feel the same thing. You don't feel it again.
On CPM.
Right.
Yes,
I
you.
Are oh, God.
In the name.
It's on you, it's on you, it's on you, it's on you.
What's that, what's
it's on you, the glory of God.
He
will not, he's not only healed. He has entered his two hands. He will heal other people of this
city.
It is that.
I am.
Ignorance is for yourself.
I can
see people of your man. Why did he so? This man here is having problems with his feet. Pain at this side. Severe pain by the temple is his feet.
All right. And you can see where it is.
Who want a name?
Can I come and get this face for
me? I'm sure the name, my name.
Can I have his face? Not inside his face.
My name.
I want us to see his face.
I see your own name.
You see, after healing, you have to maintain your healing.
Why
never ever say yes or no? And you go back doing the same thing that brings the sickness. Then why do you want the healing?
I don't know why you're saying.
Because the problem is for the healing, but the problem is I cannot maintain your healing. You don't go back doing the same things.
Be healed.
Be
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes, you do.
Amen.
Amen.
My brother here has been experiencing a distribution of the rigs.
And pain come back no more. I command you to get out of it.
And
never come back again.
And then
Jesus. Check your wrist. Let this one influence. Everybody here. Raise your hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Your miracle working power. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Wow. Thank you, Father. You are free. Raise your hands, worship the Lord. Counseling, you should not go back to the former days. The pastor says, pick his son up, get close to him, and organize counseling for him. You should not go back. He will spoil his experience. Right now, he's free. You should not go back. Please, let me say this. Go and sing no more.
But I will come for your body view.
I beg you.
The pastor, and if you
go and go ahead. Precious Jesus, you are wonderful. We thank you for the healings, the miracles, and the supernatural. Thank you for that word. We are grateful, Lord. Thank you that everyone here is receiving a touch. That you are going back with testimonies. Your destinies are changed. I bless your name.
You shout
it. And let everybody shout it with their
amen.
I want the whole nations
of God,
those who are bound by the Spirit of God, to know that the seed of God will make us in us. And we are being changed into the very image of the Son of God. To have one of these days.
I surrender, yeah. In mighty ruler, King of all the earth, we bow.